Hello everyone, welcome back to the last video of this assembling of imaging system. So as we saw in the previous video, we have some alternative for depth cameras. One of them is Kinect version 2, Kinect 2. And if you wanted to use this device, we need a baby computer with the USB 3 port. So we cannot use the Raspberry. We change it to, another baby computer. It's Latte Panda. It has the USB 3 port that we can connect the port of the Kinect to that. And to USB 2. We can use it for the mouse and keyboard. And we have the HDMI cable, and we have the Ethernet here, and so on. So it's almost the same with the Raspberry. And also we have operating system of Windows on this. I will see how does it work. So we use this for capturing the depth image. Also, it's capable of getting the RGB images. You can use both of them. And if you see, this is the camera here, and also for the depth camera is also there. So for this, we will go to the screen. We will jump to the screen of the Latte Panda. And we see how we can capture an image. And then after that, I will show you how we can remotely connect to that with our host computer. So, okay, just we will connect the HDMI cable to the HDMI port that we have here. Okay, so by this, if we connect this, I make it on. So there is a power button here. So it should be, hold it or press it for some seconds, and then it will be up. Okay. So let's see if it's pop up. So that's the Windows, so it's not as fast as the Linux, but it came up and you can see this. You can enter your password. Excuse me. Okay. And then when it opened the Windows, we can see how we can run the depth camera. Okay, so we have SDK. That is actually we adjusted for our purposes for defining a time lapse. So we give it a time lapse for example 15 minutes, 20 minutes to this, and it will capture the image based on that time lapse. So if you wanted to have the color images, you can run this SDK. If you want to have the depth images, you can run it, and also you can run both of them at the same time. So if I wanted to capture an image in the depths, so let me to return it in this site, so you can see different objects that are here, and you can see the difference between them. So if I run it for the depths camera, you will okay, see this. Okay, we have, for example, mouse closer to the camera. So as you see, that this is the distance of the camera. It's much closer to the distance of the mouse. It's much closer to the camera. So it shows it with more black pixels. So actually, my body is either far from the camera or the sensor. So it shows us the more gray pixels, and then my background is also very far from me. So it has some limitation. For example, one of the limitation is that your object should be, I can say, around in the brochure you can see that your object should be far from the sensor with the 80 centimeter, but in the practice, I recommend you to keep this distance as 120 centimeters or 150 centimeters, and then it can distinguish the object with the between the distance between two objects with the 1 centimeter distance. So this is some limitation that you have, but as you are as you will working on the plants and plants goes up. You can easily recognize each object on this soil, leaf, seedling, and so on, a hypocotyl or any organ of your plant with such these images. So this is the how we can run the depth camera, and now we just jump to the host computer. And I will show you how we can remotely connect to the camera instead of this. Okay, I just disconnect the HDMI cable from the Latapanda and just connect it to my computer. And just I will use my screen. And then again, I will check if it's on the same network as my host computer. My laptop is there. So with that, yes, we will see the new IP address here. If I ping it, so when you will see this, you don't need to ping it, but just in case, I will ping also it. 192, 168, 43, 185. And you can see here that it's replied in the 8 milliseconds, 17 milliseconds, and so on. So, and then you realize that, okay, it is on the same network, and then you can just remote desktop connection. You can enter the IP address. So I already entered it, 192.168.43.185, and then just connect. It will try to connect to the computer, and then it will show, maybe it will ask you a passport before going to this screen, and then it jumped to the screen, and we can see, as you see here, at the top you will see the IP address of your computer, your Latapanda, and then you will see the screen, and you can do any modification here. For example, if you want to, for example, open a new screen or open a new folder. So as it's also based on the speed that you have, maybe it's a little slower, but if you use the wire cable, it's a little faster. So by this, for example, you can make it maximize, or if you want, you can close it, and then again you can open the SDK, and then I said that it's modified. We modified the SDK based on our purposes to capture an image in a time lapse. So here you will see that, okay, easily we don't need to. We can connect to the computer, and we can get rid of monitor, mouse, and keyboard. So okay, I think by this step we will finish this video, and hope you enjoyed from this video series, and please don't hesitate to send a message to me. If you have any problem of the installation, if you have any problem of connecting to your Raspberry, Latapanda, or any other mini computers, I will reply you as soon as possible. So thank you again for watching us. Have a good time. Enjoy the rest of the course. Bye.